of organizations such as ours, yours, the role of government, before we talk about preparing future leaders, is really to operationally express and define the future we want. Because if we can say, what is this future we want, then we will move to the second question is, what sort of competences do we require to drive us to that future? The future is, to my mind, spoken as if it's something that is could be taken for granted, that when you say future and I say future, that we mean the same thing other than the moment past now. And I think a lot of the time, leaders do not take enough time to articulate their long-term future vision and to articulate who should drive that future vision. If we knew where we are trying to go, then we can start to create a network of leaders according to the competences that we require. And that's what will help us to approximate the building of that leadership. Because leadership is not in a vacuum, leadership has context. So that to me is the first thing that governments and organizations should do. Once we have a clear vision, as clear as we can be, since we can't predict the future with any exactitude, but once we have a clear vision, a workable vision, and we've identified the competencies, I cannot overemphasize quality education. Quality education that is relevant to the context and very explicitly saying, what are the core qualities of a leader that we want, and ensuring that those qualities are built into a quality education from a very early age. You don't try to transform somebody into an effective leader just as they are leaving the university, when you have allowed them to actually amass a lot of traits and competences that may not necessarily align with the future leaders that you want. And then I think in doing that, we have to really be very conscientious not to just recycle social inequalities and social privileges, because invariably from country to country to country, you find that children of people who were in political leadership take it for granted that they will take after the ghosts of their grandfathers or their grandmothers. Children of academics tend to do that way, the role modeling. So one of the ways, if we want to have a chance at having the best leaders we can have, is also making conscious decisions to break the intergenerational inheritance of whatever, be it poverty, be it lack of leadership, be leadership in certain spheres. So that to me would be a collective approach to leadership, an inclusive approach to leadership, and a just approach to leadership. So I hope that's what we could do.